It all started with a young student named May. She is a normal girl, a normal student, but most of her days in school, she always faces certain types of issues. Most of the time, she was bullied by her other classmates inside their room. This helpless and confused girl can't do anything but look down. The words, "Why is this happening? Why are they doing this?" always cross her innocent mind. She was overheard by a student outside the room, and this student gazed from the glass window. This student is Mark. He didn't want to get involved, so he left and carried on. Inside the classroom, May was still bullied, even if she can take no more of it. One of the bullies is named Anna. Anna became furious and irritated when May cried, so Anna called in Antonio, her friend, when suddenly, Mark appeared and protected May from him. Mark warned Antonio to stop and leave them. He is holding his emotions and he wants to do something. May stops her, telling him that it is not necessary. Mark knew that doing nothing is the best thing to do. He stopped and smiled at May. May invited Mark to her house as a form of gratitude. May toured him around her house. Several minutes later, she told Mark that she would go to get some snacks. While he is waiting, Mark noticed May's phone is ringing second by second because of the notifications. He suspiciously checked the phone and found out that even in social media, May was being bullied. At first, May was shy. She doesn't know what to do and say to the officer. She is too afraid to ask for help. But then again, Mark helped her and insisted to come in the office with her and tell everything. Both of them decided to go talk to the counselor and tell everything that was happening. The counselor called Anna to go talk about the mess she made. Anna and the counselor had a private talk. The counselor did everything that he could to give Anna the best advice and words so that she and her friends would change. Anna told the counselor that she was truly sorry and that she won't bully others ever again and that she was enlightened. Everything is clear and settled. But when Anna got out of the office, she saw a familiar scene. Two boys were bullying a helpless one. She shouted at them and told them to stop or she'll report them to the office. The two bullies stopped and Anna offered her hand to the boy and smiled at him. When people hurt you over and over, Think of them like sandpaper. They may scratch and hurt you a bit, but in the end, you end up polished and they end up useless. People should be able to live a life free from bullying and harassment, and it is time that we all took a stand against this.